Hello, hello, beautiful Taurus, Gemini, Cusp, and our cross watchers. How are you all? Welcome to my channel. I am Tierka Love. How are you all doing? All right, y'all. So we are going to take a look into your love connection for the month of November. Please know that these will be general messages, all right? If you are interested in a personal or private read, I do offer those. Just check the description box below. I do have my email address listed. If you all are active on Facebook, Instagram, and or TikTok, and you would like to check me out on my other social media platforms, feel free to just go down to the description box below. Click there on the links. I do have them listed, okay? All right, y'all. So, if you are new here, again, welcome. I really hope you're going to find some messages here that will be helpful. If you all are returning, welcome back, you all. Thank you to everyone that has previously liked, subscribed, shared, commented, or even just watched. I greatly appreciate it, okay? All right, now, so let's get started towards Gemini Cusp. In love for the month of November. All right, let's look at the situation here. Taurus, Gemini, Cusp, in love for the month of November. We have baiting, all right? So someone is in it to, it's just like this seducing type of energy here, okay? Possibly using, you know, it will only be good if we do not just flaunt it everywhere here, okay? But it's like we're trying to use our goods to kind of get what we want out of a person or out of this situation. That's a spider. All right. Okay. I am going to dig a little deeper, but let's keep going. Let's see. Your feelings. So you feel like you need to either delete some text messages and or calls here. You feel like you are wanting this person to possibly clean out their address book, only have your number here in the book here. This is possibly a situation where we have a second number or we have two phones here, okay? All right, so the challenge in this connection or the challenge between you two, it would be all these thoughts the mind is leading here. So you're either dealing with someone who's not following their heart here. This could be a situation where this person is being very logical, or living inside of their head, which is causing some type of restrictions, okay? Let's look at the recent past. In the recent past, you could have been kind of pressuring this person to decide what they want to do here. It could be a situation where you feel like it's taking this person a long time to decide what they want to do, okay? Let's see, what do you know about this situation? You do know that things are hot and cold between you and this person. You do know that this person is kind of sending a lot of mixed signals, and it's either you or the person, okay? You just put it where it goes. But we don't quite know what we want in this situation, all right? Let's see, what are you two, well, the near future. That's too many. All right, so let's look at the near future. Taurus, Gemini, Cusp, in love for the month of November. All right, almost there. The answers are close, okay? So without it, you're almost there. A new beginning is close here. I am going to dig a little deeper. We're going to get some clarity to see, check into this new beginning here. But I feel like you're not going to give up here. And there is a door that is opening. So it could be new opportunities or someone new for somebody here. You could be meeting someone new here. There could be a situation where, what are you moving towards? You could find out some things over the phone here. Someone could call you and say something. Or you're going to catch maybe somebody in the act doing something here. Okay. Let's see what is influencing you internally. All right, the internal influence here, it is just, it's like inside here. You feel like this person is giving you false hope. You feel like this person have no intentions on making a commitment here, okay? But your external influence, this could be a long distance relationship here, or maybe you could be going to get ready to go see your person externally here, the external influence. I feel like you are wanting to maybe travel here or take some type of trip with this person. External influence. Let's look more into external. All right. So you do feel like this is a life partner. This is someone that you do want to move forward with here, even if it is a long distance relationship. Okay. For some of you all, you could meet this person at work. This could be like someone at work here. Okay. So let's look at your fears, hopes, and or fears towards Gemini cusp. All right, we're fearing that maybe you won't get everything that you deserve in this connection here. You're fearing maybe cutting your losses in this situation, but you are hoping your fears here. I feel like you're getting fed up. Feminine energy is getting fed up. Feminine energy. It's just has had enough here, possibly in regards to a conversation here or your person being more vulnerable, but you are hoping that before you completely cut your losses that this person is going to come in and you two have a heart-to-heart conversation. Okay, let's see the near towards the latter part of the month of November. I do see that someone here is still going to be playing hard to get. And it could be this bit of rejection. Maybe you're going to reject this person towards the end of the month here due to we got once a cheater, always a cheater here. Okay. All right. So let's keep going. Let me dig in a little deeper. Let's see. Taurus, Gemini, cusp. Taurus, Gemini, cusp. Let's look more into the situation. All right, so in the situation here, you are open and ready to receive. What are you open and ready to receive? Some communication here. I feel like in the situation, either you or your person's kind of regretting the actions, but not really expressing it. So we're kind of keeping everything in. So I feel like you're open and ready to receive some answers, okay? How do you feel about the situation? Look more into the cleanup with this deleting the text message. You feel like that you do want growth here in the situation between you and this person. Yep, you feel like this is someone that you're supposed to be in a union with here. This could be someone that you are in a relationship with here. Okay, let's look more into the challenge here. The challenge would be you allowing your spirit guides to kind of help you and guide you. The challenge would be ego is kind of, maybe you're dealing with someone who is allowing their ego to kind of get in the way here. There's a divine intervention as well. So this is like a sudden change that had to take place here. Okay. In the recent past, tell us more about the too late. Okay. It was too late. We had a third party situation here. So you was waiting on this person to make a decision. You either got a little detached and cold, or this person got a little detached and cold here. Okay. What do you know about this situation? You do know that you're very guarded. And you know that you possibly are afraid to be vulnerable here, or that is your person here. Okay. You do know there's a lot of chemistry here between you and this person, and there's a lot of passion. Let's look more into the, what are you moving towards in the near? Okay, so we have these toxicities. We have these patterns that maybe you're going to break free from, okay? Maybe you're going to break free from the toxicity. You're going to come out of a situation where you do feel bound here. Looking more into the stringing you along, the internal influence. The internal influence, what's influencing you internally is you're kind of longing for this person here, okay? During separation or during times that you two are not together, you're longing to be with this person. External influence would be a completion, cycles here, ending out cycles. So something possibly is going to maybe come to an end here. Or this is you saying you want to really, you want to change here. You feel like in a situation with these patterns, this person is not expressing, it's possibly a third party situation where you are in some type of union with this person. Externally, I do feel like you are getting fed up here and you're either wanting to end things, even though you do know that this is a soulmate here. Okay. What are your hopes and or fears? Let's look more into the feminine energy being fed up in this heart-to-heart conversation. Gifts. You are hoping to receive some type of gift. You are hoping to be able to celebrate something here. But you're fearing that possibly this person is not going to be, is not going to open up to give you whether these gifts is in conversation or something tangible here, okay? For some of you all, I feel like you're ready for some type of proposal. And if this, it's like I feel like you're giving this person an ultimatum, okay? All right. You are hoping to harvest what you have, reap what you have sown, but you're fearing that you won't reap what you have sown here, okay? Let's look at the near future. Towards the latter part of the month, I see suffering emotionally. There's some things in the past that we're kind of holding on to that, or the situation here is going to cause, like, for you to feel emotionally drained here, I feel, okay? So I feel like in the near future, or towards the latter part of the month of October, you need to be more open, be open for new opportunities. I feel like you have to take this leap of faith here, okay? You have to stand your ground. You have to do what you know is right in this situation. Let's see how your person feels. Taurus, Gemini, Cusp. What's this person feeling, Taurus, Gemini, Cusp? All right, they are sending you mixed signals, okay? That cloudy space between hot and cold is their way of telling you that they're not totally sure if they are into you here. They do want to remove the mask that they have been wearing. They do want to reveal their true feelings towards you. They do listen to a lot of music, and this music, it kind of reminds them of you. It brings them closer to you here. Through music, they start to see how special the connection is, okay? They do fear your wrath, though. They know that you're no longer going to entertain their half-hearted efforts here. So, I feel like if they're going to continue to play, then it's like they might end up exiting out of the situation because they know that you're getting fed up. They know that you have been in this situation. And they may not be ready to give you exactly what you deserve, okay? Let's get some advice. You got strictly sexual, okay? This connection is passionate, but it's not enduring, all right? I do see fate, so for some of you here, this is a distant partnership. There's a stability. This relationship can't stand the test of time, which is telling me that you two have been through a lot here. But someone is having a lot of obsessive thoughts in this connection, and this person do feel some remorse for the way that they treated you, okay? All right, so Taurus, Gemini, Cusp, and our cross watchers, that is your message. I really hope it will be helpful. Thank you all so much for joining me. Thank you all for your likes, subscribe, shares, comments. I greatly appreciate it. I will see you all next time. Bye.